I'll never stole no horse.
The horse.
Keep out of our business. No offense, preacher.
You can't do that. There's been no trial.
Tain't necessary. Not when we catch him red-handed.
You can't hang a man for stealing horses.
I declare, Desperado, the preacher's defending you. Who'd have thought a man of God would stick up for the likes of you?
Leave the reverend pray for this here, Desperado. But we'll hang him first.
Reckon with God, my son. You'll soon be face to face with him. Pray for his forgiveness for yourself and for them.
Get out of here, preacher. I don't want to pray.
Well, he'll be frying in hellfire before I get through.
Oh.
Hell can't be any worse than here. Go on, get it over with.
You shouldn't steal. Ain't that what the Bible say?
Hey, hang him over.
Preacher. That's right, bring the Bible, preacher. Bring it to me.
Thanks be to God. Untied.
Just his hands, though, just his hands.
Ain't no use in our going through all this. It's just a waste of time.
All right, but make it quick, preacher. You gotta hang anyhow, Desperado. Start praying.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord for showing you the path to salvation. The Almighty will hear your prayers and be with you in your hour of need. The noose is drawing tighter, so repent, my son. Repent! And God will save you. Yes, repent, that you may be forgiven for your sin. You in a moment will be at peace and know the joys of everlasting life. Now, Steve.
Guns for hire, if you should need me. and there's no one alive I fear. But when you've got nothing to lose, it don't matter how hard you fall. Your fate you can pick and choose, 'cause you're ready to risk your all. I ride across the plain alone with just a gun, for no one knows better than I. Trouble goes wherever I go, for I'm the man, the one they call Desperado. There's no one alive I fear. No, there's nothing that I've got to lose. And if I die, then it's destiny. When a man is a real desperado, that's the way it's gotta be.
I reckon there was confusion. You only aimed to borrow that horse, huh? Like I borrowed this preacher's get-out. Lucky for you, I did.
You have a smoke, Jonathan?
Why, sure. Yeah.
Thanks.
Guess you could use one. Well, what have you been doing these last 2 years? Where you been?
Here and there.
What kind of business?
I lived.
Where are you going now?
Away from here.
Always alone, eh?
I was born that way.
Oh, it's just Confederates in retreat. Come with me to Carrion. Certain churches there are filled with gold just waiting for us to take it.
No. Here.
Think it over. You won't live long if you go around risking your life for a fool horse.
I might die, but I'll do it alone.
Reverend, the Major's respects, sir, and if you care to come with us, he'd be much obliged. Some of our boys are wounded bad.
All right. I don't have the cookbook with me, though.
We're to comfort's all they want, sir.
Amen.
So long, preacher, and thanks. Hope you find a church to your liking. Give me your horse.
drag me to the buzzards. Please, mister.
Not a chance. I can't wait till you die.
You won't have to wait long. Take my gun. If you ever get to a place called Overton, give it to my father. He made it. He's blind, but he sees with his hands. Sam Flanagan, my father. Overton, far away, around 75 miles north of here. A ghost town now. Only my father lives there. We were gonna buy a ranch with that money.
You say Overton?
Please, Pa. Leave Overton. Buy the ranch. Use the money I sent you. That's what it's for. The ranch. Buy the ranch. I want you to. You will. Won't you? For me, Bill?
Not a soul in sight.
Why, sure. They sent us to a ghost town. They sent us because nobody's in it. And now you're surprised because there's no one around here?
Well, let's have a look. This place is like the Western gold rush towns they wrote about in the papers back at home.
Come on. You trying to let on you know how to read now?
Well, maybe somebody read me the stories.
There.
Hear that?
Two soldiers from the cavalry.
Why didn't you call? They may have wanted us.
But they didn't stop. They went on by. Besides, they were both so ugly. Neither of them could have been Bill.
Maybe I exaggerate. You're tired of hearing me talk so about him, aren't you?
No. I think it's wonderful to hear someone talk about the person they love.
I always reckon every one of our soldiers has news of Bill. Tell me the truth, Katie. Have you heard the South is defeated and they want to stop the fighting? Now tell me everything you know.
In Tallville, Sam, when I delivered the two revolvers, they said they were worthless and that now you'd be better off making spades and hatchets.
I know. So they could get those guns at $10 apiece. If we had Bill, they'd respect us more than that.
You have to pick the most ramshackle house in town to stay in?
It ain't no worse than the others.
cholera epidemic's over, why ain't there anybody here now?
Because the Yankees will be getting in here soon. And that scares the folks more than any old cholera. You start a fire. I'll get the rifles. Oh!
Dang varmint. This is no town. It's a swamp.
Sam! Sam! Sam Flanagan! Sam! Sam! Sam Flanagan! It's me, Bill!
Bill? Hey, you, Bill? Bill? Am I dreaming or is it really you? Why don't you answer, son?
No, it's no dream.
Bill. Welcome back. Let's go inside. Home again. Everything's just as it was. Please, Katie. Tell me why you're so different. I want to hear about everything that's happened to you all these years. I hardly know you.
You know this? I still have it.
Yes. Years. That's a long while.
Thanks.
I'm Katie.
I wrote to you often about her, Bill.
I haven't received any letters from home for a long time.
My right hand does everything for me. Takes my work and travels about making sales. Her folks all died from the cholera, poor child. You're not wounded, are you, Bill?
No.
Tell me, Katie. Tell me the truth.
No, he's not wounded.
You see, I was right not to leave Overton with the other folks. I knew I should have waited for you. If I hadn't reason to wait, I'd rather die in our house.
I can't see what I'm eating. What is this? Polecat?
You're better off not looking at it.
Hmm.
Hey. How much gold will there be on that wagon?
I don't know. Heard tell there's supposed to be 2 months' pay for the division. Figure it out. I can't.
Two rebel rats like us. And all that gold.
Is the war going well for us, son?
No. It's not, Paul. It's going very bad. As soon as it's over, we'll buy that ranch. We must.
Yes, the ranch.
You haven't spent it, have you?
What?
The money.
How could you even say such a thing, your father? It's all right. I've even added a bit to it myself.
Is it in a safe place?
The very place you chose. That flour mill of Russell's. But one place is as good as another. Who'd have think of looking for that much money in Overton nowadays? But enough of that. Tell me about yourself, son. I want to hear all that's happened.
Not just now. Brings back bad memories. And I'm tired. We'll talk more about it tomorrow. Good night.
Good night, son.
Good night.
Night.
Maybe I'm unfair to him. I don't know. Seems mighty changed.
It's the war. It's the war that makes him like that. When it's all over, he'll be just the way he was before.
Are you still awake, Katie? Oh. When I'm real tired, I can't sleep. And you?
I saw the light, and I...
Well, I wanted to make sure that my father's money was still where I had hidden it.
I know. I've been guarding the money. I sleep in the back of the house, because I can see the mill from that room.
Am I like you thought I'd be? Tell me the truth. I understand. I'm different. Well, better or worse?
I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go.
Remember, no killing.
Right, no killing. The more use to us alive. Tie them up. Are you the ones who were sent to receive the gold here? Are you the ones? Are there more soldiers in town?
Thank you.
guess we're not the only people in town.
I saw two soldiers ride by today, but I didn't expect them to stop.
Listen, get my father's money.
You gonna take it away?
It'd be safer with me.
Come out of there! Come out! Toss down your gun and come out! You and the girl! I'll give you 10 seconds.
Stay out of sight.
Toss over your gun and come out of there.
Velasco. The terror of Texas. The desperado. It's all right. He's a friend.
You had so many amigos, Lucy. How can you remember them all, huh?
Yeah, I know him. He's a skunk. I ought to know. We teamed up for a while. That's right, Asher. I know him very well.
So then he ain't a real soldier.
Steve, a soldier?
So you're the famous desperado. You're not alone.
Who's in there with you? There's a girl in there. Who is she?
What do you care?
Pick up his gun, Togo. Search the lock. No one. The girl ain't there.
No one.
I judge by this masquerade that you're waiting for the military wagon to get here, too. Right, Steve?
What else? Guess we're all in the same boat. Now I'll have to split with you.
Take those soldiers inside. There should be a blind man in town.
That's right. Over there. You'd better leave the blind man alone.
Why?
If the Rebs arrive and know about him, they'll wonder where he is.
Steve always has the last word. You'd better all get used to it. If you want to go in there, you have to kill me first.
She lives with the blind men. She'll stay with us now.
So that's what you were doing in the mill. You're always ready to mix business with pleasure.
What is wrong with you? Why don't you speak to me, chica? Say something sweet to me, Chiquita. Come on. Come on, let me hear your little voice.
Even if you manage to get the gold, they'll catch you afterwards. Wanna hang? Y'all be hanged by that time.
Find him.
What difference does it make? I needed someone. Why did you disappear that way, Steve? And without a word?
You can't always choose the way you have to do some things.
I've missed you.
Jim, Jake, one of you at the north end of town, the other at the south.
No.
It won't be long now. So stay awake. Watch for that wagon.
Katie? Katie!
Get him out of the way. And no tricks here. Katie?
It's me, Sam.
I've been listening to them. Who are they? Troublemakers? I wonder what they're about. You think we should wake up Bill?
No, we better not wake Bill. We have to be getting along to the house now, Sam. Come on. It's just some drummers. They're going to spend the night in a saloon.
Strange. It's been months since we've seen a stray animal, even. And now, all of a sudden...
Sam, try to get some rest now. I'm going back to the saloon and make the visitors comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
You bought me this comb one day, remember?
No.
You don't remember? Have I aged too much? Tell me the truth, have I? You didn't have to bother. I'd have killed him with this.
Don't worry, Togo. Just wait. In Red Rock, there'll be plenty of ladies for you.
That wagon heading this way, Asher.
Good. About time. Well, all right, we better untie them and clean those two ribs up a little before it gets here. Give him a hand.
Yeah! Ah! Aye! Yeah!
There's storming here.
That explains your temper.
Day's getting hotter. But it's better weather than we had for the fight at Twin Forks. Yep, last year it was, just about this time, and just about this time of day, too, when a damn Yankee mortar shell made off of this arm in passing. You reckon they gave my poor arm a Christian burial?
Hey, that must be the town there.
You won't last long if you try anything.
No officer, sir.
The area is filled with deserters. They don't want to lose this wagon. I was sent to command this escort.
That's your business, sir, but I'm afraid we can't stay. We've got to head straight back to the camp at Black River, and we'll also be needing your horses for the ride back. Those were the colonel's orders, sir.
Right. How was your trip?
Well, that road liked to bounce our brains loose.
I hope nothing else was bounced out of place.
There's been a change in orders, though, because the shipment's in the grain sack for the horses, not in them coffins. Wish you luck, sir.
Same to you.
Thank you.
Unload it. Put it inside there.
Go on, that's your job. Get to work, Rebs.
Well done, Steve. There, you see how easy it was?
That was good thinking of those Rebs. We're going to look inside.
Asher, I'm going to get rid of the wagon.
Right.
No tricks in the meantime.
Open the other.
Payroll. That gold, it got to be here.
Maybe these two know something. Where is that gold? Where is that gold?
In the grain sack for the horses.
Where's your friend? Where did he go? I said, where is he? Let's go.
Don't shoot.
Look in those sacks, you two.
Mira. They're here, Asher. Gold cartwheels.
You thought of everything. You didn't figure how well I know this part of the country. A lot better than you.
Please let me go back to the old man.
Is he your father?
No. But he needs me.
And Steve? I saw how you looked at him. Forget him. It's all over for him now. You can join the old codger just as soon as we leave.
Friend isn't a man of his word. He was ready to take your share as well.
Get off.
You.
Now try and get up, desperado. What do we do with these two Rebs?
Untie them. Let them go.
Son.
Go back, Sam. Sam. Back.
What have they done to you, Bill? Where are you? Why don't you answer me? What's wrong, son? What's going on? What have you rats done to my son? I'll kill you if you touch Bill.
Yeah, what, son?
No!
Where are you? Come on,
shoot!
I'm behind you. Come on, Grandpa, come on, shoot! Hey, where are you,
hey,
rats?
Here we are.
Come on,
shoot me!
Murderer! Here!
Can't help you. They'll pay, though.
Sam!
Ah! Oh.
I want to kill him. I can't forget what he's done to me.
On your horses.
You can join your friend. She must love you very much if she had the courage to help play that scene. She did a very good job of it. I thought she'd killed you too. Leave that gun. It belonged to Sam.
I'll bring it back. Afterwards.
He tried to defend you, and they killed him.
The ones who killed him are going to pay for it.
You'll never find them again. Or is it the money? Is that why you're after him? If you go north, they'll capture you in that uniform.
I've grown fond of it.
Steve, they'll kill you.
No, Katie. It's my turn to kill.
Mm-hmm. the play, alone with just a gun, and no one knows. If I die, then that's destiny. When a man is a real desperado, that's the way it's gotta be.
Able-bodied Confederate. Y'all applaud our hero officer.
I'm proud of you. You got away.
What do you got against the cavalry?
Nothing. They're a fast outfit when it comes to retreating.
Them rabbits run the Yankees straight into our houses.
Don't worry. Swine like you will be doing business with them in no time. War is an ugly affair. Soldiers die young, while cowards keep right on going. Thank you.
Chiquita, eh? We have beautiful time together tonight, eh?
Hey, you, wake up. Come on, wake up. What's the matter with you? Hey, Mike, give me a hand. He's dead as a doornail. Let's get him out of here. Gives the place a bad name.
Now, believe me, friends, in times like these, you shouldn't invest your money in a savings bank, much less in a sugar bowl. You should invest your money. Invest your money, sir. It's just 2 cents a share. Just two. How about you, sir? Just two pennies.
Excuse me.
What's that, ma'am?
Could you kind of explain, sir, what sort of return I've collected in a
year? It's all down here in black and white.
Oh, well.
The Western Union Railroad doubled your money.
I reckon I'll take $10 worth.
Well, now, that's 500 shares. I congratulate you, ma'am. You are now part owner of the railroad. Union dollars. No Confederate money. That would take 10,000 Confederate dollars. Now, who else wants to ride the rails of progress with the great Western Union?
$1,000 worth.
Union money? That's only 50 shares.
Look here, can I have just one share for 2 cents?
Why, you most certainly may have, ma'am. Here
you
are. How about you, sir? Confederate, sir? Speak up, folks. Don't miss your chance to buy into the great Western Union Railroad. Only $2 for 100 shares of gilt-edged railroad stock. And remember, the future of this country lies in railroads.
Be back in a few days. Don't you worry, Judge. I'll send you those warrants as soon as they get here.
Excuse me, sir.
Oh, hello. I'll be right with you.
Anything else I can do for you, Judge? Sure.
No, that's all. Thank you.
Have a good day.
Thank you. Bye. Come on inside.
Wait for me downstairs. Just heard Jim was killed during a fight in the saloon. No one knows who did it.
Well, don't tell me you're all torn up about it.
No, I just hope nobody's found out about that gold. Look, I don't like this place. I've already told you that. Why did you want to stop here? We've got to get out of here. Right away. I don't like it.
That's too bad, because you're not going to make me get back on that horse again and ride hundreds of miles just to please you.
This time we'll go by stage to Texas.
No, I'm staying here. You can't make me go with you. I don't want to.
Don't say that, Lucy. Don't talk that way.
I've told you. I don't want to go.
You will come, whether you want to or not.
Well, Judge, there's a little confusion in the ranks of justice these days, my friend. But I think the military must be even more confused, eh?
It would take too long to explain.
Sit down, my boy. Sit down. You smell the perfume around here, too? This place reeks of coal.
A few minutes ago, a man left here.
Ah, yes. He wanted seats on my stage for him and his lady friend and 3 other men.
What did you tell him?
I said, all right. I don't think he's traveling with empty pockets. Want to do the job together?
No. But I think you can help me. Listen.
It's so hot.
The lady's not comfortable. Why don't you come and sit over here? In a little while, I want to make a business stop.
We'd rather not, Judge.
I'm sorry, but it's important. I must wait for an official to bring in the warrants for the arrest of the Asher gang.
My friends here might be of help to you. They'll ride on later, if horses can be found for them.
Where we're stopping, there'll be a farmer. You haven't seen Judge Tracy at all?
No, not yet, sir.
Two of these gentlemen will wait for him then. I have a court appointment, Dermot. They can fetch the documents to me there.
Everything settled?
Sure. When do we get our share?
When you finish your job here. Then we'll divide everything up.
Well, I just want my horses back.
Naturally.
In 3 days' time, I'll meet you two in Fort Worth.
And I want to thank you for cooperating with the law.
You're welcome.
This kind gentleman here will furnish you with the horses you need. I'm sorry, ma'am, but unfortunately there aren't any refreshments here.
Never mind. It's not important.
And I want to thank you, too, for your cooperation. Ready? No!
Coronado.
Señor, mis muchos pecados. I am a miserable sinner. I stole and I kill, but never I kill a man unarmed. No, not that. Not that. Not that. No, never. Not that. Oh!
We're turning around.
Maybe the driver took the wrong turn.
Done anything but look out of that window since we left.
Hold it!
If you're a judge, I'm the president of the Confederacy.
Out to rob me, huh? First you got rid of my men.
You're only waiting for the right moment.
That's it, isn't it? Why we stopped?
I think that we've arrived.
You're wrong. We're not across the Texas border.
Hey, sir!
Come back! Yeah, yeah, ah! Come back here! Yeah! Stop! Asher!
That gun won't help you. That was your last bullet, Asher. I wouldn't want it so easy, Asher. Still have time to die like a man. Because you're looking death in the face, Asher. Are you ready? Shouldn't have done that. Call yourself a man? You still have bullets, Asher. Try again. Go on. See better with mud in your eyes? The gun's right there. Come on. Now shoot it. Ha. Here.
couldn't see either. Remember, Asher?
That's your order, sir.
Hey! Hey!
He was making off for the last of our gold reserve. We've been chasing it for 10 days.
I'm afraid you've made a mistake. This man is a judge, Captain. He was helping me. He was guarding the gold. There's the thief you're looking for. And a murderer as well.
You mean... he's a judge after all. He was telling us the truth then. Untie him.
Your Honor, if you hold out your hand, sir. There you are, sir.
My apologies, sir.
Goodbye, Steve. Looks as if I'm destined to be a judge of modest means.
Aren't we going together?
No, Lucy.
I hate you, Steve.
That's not true.
You're right. Steve, goodbye.
Captain, would you escort them as far as Dermont?
Yes, with pleasure.
Thank you, sir.
Good luck to you. Call them forward!
Giddy up! Ha!
Take the money that belonged to old Sam. Buy a ranch of your own. I wish you'd think it over. There, beyond the mountain. It's good land. It's what old Sam would have wanted.
Why don't you stay?
I can't now. I still have to come to terms with myself.
Will we see each other again?
I'll be passing through.
You come back soon.
I'll ride across the plain.